Subscribe and press the bell icon to enjoy more exciting and enlightening videos from Dheya.
Welcome to this new episode of Dheya Cups. And I'm Anirudh Naveen, first year student at Hansraj College, University of Delhi, a student of history and a passionate writer myself. So it's wonderful being part of this initiative by the Dheya Career Mentors, and I'm going to start off with this whole concept of a cub itself, because Dheya Cubs, as we call it. When we think of cubs, we think of freedom, we think of, you know, energy, of enthusiasm, right? And something that we readily associate with students also, because what students bring to the fore is that raw innocence and purity that even adults are envious of, right? But when it comes to one aspect, things become so serious, right? So difficult. That is studies. Suddenly, there's this big burden that comes on us. Oh God, you have to study these many books. Oh God, you have to study these many chapters. My God, and then all the kind of discussions that move around this aspect of studies. And today, I'm going to engage with this whole question of how we can make studies and academics more enjoyable. Right, and let's remember one thing, that when you study, your academics is not defined only by your studying that one book. It's defined by a plethora of factors around you. And today we're going to try to, you know, understand how we can actually orient those factors towards your ultimate goal of scoring good marks in your examinations, right? Let's accept it. We all want to score good marks. So the first thing that I have for you is something very basic. And that is to plan. Now, what I mean by planning is not just the normal planning that I'll do this, then I'll do this, then I'll do this. What I mean is plan smartly. Do not, you know, try to kind of overwhelm yourself and say that, you know, I'm going to be studying for 4 hours or 5 hours today, and I'm going to be doing this. I'm going to be watching a movie also. I'm going to do, you know, you need to ensure that your planning is structured in such a way that when you are in the highest of energies, that time you can sit down with a book and you can read it. So for some it's in the evening, for some it's in the morning, for some it's in the afternoon. Whenever it is, you know, you need to be fresh, and you need to be fresh to receive information, to receive inputs and to process them properly. So respect every, you know, respect your schedule, respect your family background and all of that, and take a decision accordingly and plan in a structured way so that you can you can begin studying purposefully. Now, your planning can also revolve around, it could start off in the morning itself. You could prepare a timetable, a very brief timetable, early in the morning, so that it remains. And today you have apps like Evernote, and I already suggest this app called Evernote because it helps you prepare a very, very nice timetable to carry your day forward. Then we come to the second aspect, and this is where I come to the point, and that is, respect your body. What I mean by respecting your body, I mean that if your body demands something, give it. You know, our body is like an engine, and we are the ones who are the drivers, who are driving the car. Now, let's say your car is on first gear, and you want to drive it at 60 kilometers an hour. Will the car really move? Will the car really go in that speed? It will instantly break down. So what do we need to ensure? We need to ensure that we give this body the rest it needs. We listen to this body. We eat only as much as this body needs, right? We don't overburden it, or we don't underwhelm it, or say, you know, don't eat that much. That kind of a balance needs to be maintained. And remember, it's this kind of balance that transmits itself into your academics. When you study, you are not just, it's not your mind that is getting engaged. There are different processes happening within your body also that you need to respect, and you need to be aware of them, right? So it's important to respect your body. You know, I know people like flaunting that I study right through the night, and I study for 16 hours in a day and all those things. It really doesn't make a difference. At the end of the day, what makes a difference is how you've understood a subject and how you can apply it in life. Barring that, studying for 15 or 16 hours doesn't make even an iota of difference in your understanding and your prospects in life. So there's no need to, you know, listen to such people. You need to respect what you have been given by the Almighty, or what you have been gifted, you know, by birth. So that's the second point. The third point is something very interesting, and that is to talk, right? So all the extroverts out there, all the ones who love blabbering, will go, wow, this is such a wonderful way of going and, you know, studying itself. Remember, this is important because we all are social creatures, right? We like people being around us. We like sharing our thoughts. We like sharing our ideas. And let me tell you, sharing your thoughts is one of the most beautiful ways of learning from others as well. You know, it's also about testing your own knowledge, in the sense when you share something with others, you are sharing a part of your own experience which others can profit from. And then in response, others will share their bit of experience, their bit of wisdom that you will certainly profit from. This kind of an exchange is something that is unique to us as Homo sapiens. So we need to be proud of it, and we need to use it to the optimum level, right? So there's no need to be bound by a cocoon. There's no need to say, "Arey, baat karne se kuch hone nahi wala. We won't get anything if we talk." There's no problem if you want to talk, right? There's a difference, remember, between talking and blabbering. If you want to blabber and if you want to talk things that really do not lead to anything conclusive, you're blabbering, right? So always remember, if you're able to talk purposefully, if you're able to engage in conversations and ask the right questions, it's an excellent habit that will always yield amazing results when you study. And it will also help you enjoy your academics further. Why? Because it ensures that, you know, your mind is channelized in a positive direction when you are sitting down with your books. Not that, you know, there is no one to talk to me, or there is no one to listen to me, and all those things are, I mean, those things must not crop up. It will really help you if you have people to confide in. Now I come to the fourth aspect, and this is something that must be stressed upon, which is being multidimensional. We all like the rainbow, right? We all like seeing different colors. We all like India because of that, because of its different colors, because it's not unilateral. It's not, you know, you're not painting things with one brush. Likewise, we should also be multidimensional. Our identity should not be only, you know what, I am a 10th or 12th standard student, right? Koi puchta hai, you answer in that way only. That is not the way in which life should be lived. It should be lived to the fullest. Maybe 6 or 7 years back, you were into art and you were into a sport, you were into painting, you were into music, dance, and suddenly it's so astonishing that many people give up these passions for the pursuit of their academics, which is not at all correct. That's the only way you can, you know, sort of let out your feelings, let out your emotions. And remember, it is these kind of activities that will actually make you focus more and even enjoy your studies, right? So remember, enjoyment is connected with productivity. The more you're able to engage with the text, the more you're able to understand a certain textbook or a certain material, the more you, it is directly connected with how you enjoy it and how you can relate to it. So please do not give up on those passions of yours. They will always, always hold you in good stead right through life, right? And then the fifth one, and I mean, this is perhaps the fitting, the icing on the cake, which is smile, right? It's the answer to all your problems in life. The more you smile, the more you're grateful for what you have been given, the more you're grateful for everything around you, the better life will move on for yourself. So remember, keep smiling, and that smile will translate itself into a wonderful academic process, into a seamless academic process that will have, you know, certain hurdles. I mean, when I say seamless, I don't mean it's just one flat trajectory, everything is going, you know, wonderfully. There will be moments when you may not feel like studying. There will be moments when you will just seem like keeping the book down. I don't want to study at all today. But remember, it's perfectly okay to be, you know, confused or to not want to study. It's perfectly fine. It happens with everyone. It's about respecting your own individuality, and it's about respecting your own strengths and your own attributes. So I hope these 5 tips were helpful. And I wish each one of you a wonderful studying experience. Once again, thank you so much, Dhea Career Mentors, for giving me this opportunity. And I wish you all a very happy new year. Wonderfully, you're moving forward.